Hello everyone, welcome to my college, Christchurch, Oxford. We recently had our annual alumni weekend, which was scaled back because of the Queen's passing. A couple of alumni asked me about my favorite memories of Christchurch, so I thought I'd share them here as well and take you on a private tour. I have to start with the Queen's visit in 2006. She was the College Visitor of Christchurch, a title that's more ceremonial than anything. But among the 38 Oxford colleges, only Christchurch, Oriel, St. Anthony's, and University College had the Queen as the royal visitor. Many prominent people have visited Christchurch, but as you can see from the crowd, we were all excited but respectful. It's hard to describe, but you feel honored to be there. I've been back to college events throughout the years, like the 40 years of Christchurch Women's Celebration, a talk about the British Empire, a boat trip along the River Isis, where the only beer they served was San Miguel, a Hong Konger's favourite. With a mix of tipsiness and seasickness, I was taken to the Alice in Wonderland tour. This is the tree where the Cheshire Cat appeared. And this little door between the Deanery and Cathedral Garden should lead to the White Rabbit. I even went behind the scenes to the Great Kitchen. Of course, there's a lot of dining and drinking in black tie. But out of all these events, the best story I've heard is about Prince Leopold, the younger son of Queen Victoria. So my recommended highlight number one is the marble bust of Prince Leopold in the Chapel of Remembrance. He came to study at Christchurch in 1872, and rumor has it he fell in love with Alice Liddell, one of the Dean's daughters. Queen Victoria would not let her son marry a commoner. Fine. He married a German princess and named their daughter Alice. When Alice Liddell had her second son, she named him Leopold and made Prince Leopold his godfather. His godson's name, Leopold Reginald Hargreaves, is on the World War I memorial in the cathedral porch. It makes my heart break. I still remember that in my first week at Christchurch, one of the tour guides made us lie on the floor in front of the altar and talked us through the architectural design. He showed us the reconstructed shrine of St. Frideswide, patron saint of Oxford. He told us to feel the inside of the shrine because there were different types of stone and hence temperature. That was pre-COVID times when people told you to touch things and you'd just do it. Anyway, highlight number two is actually the St. Frideswide window behind it. Frideswide was said to be an 8th century Saxon princess. She devoted her life to God and became a nun. But King Elgar of Leicester was obsessed to make her his wife. The stained glass windows depict the escape that Frideswide made into the woods in Oxford. The overzealous king was struck by lightning sent from God. Frideswide prayed for him, and he ultimately left her in peace. What's interesting is that the windows were made in 1859 by the Pre-Raphaelite artist Edward Burne-Jones. In the last panel depicting St. Frideswide in her deathbed, there's a Victorian flush toilet, a loo, 1,000 years ahead of her time. Also, the supposed coat of arms of Oxfordshire were actually the other way around. One explanation was that Edward Burne-Jones was an Exeter College graduate playing a prank on us. An alternative reason was that he's just trying to thank the Victorian sanitary engineer Thomas Crapper for sponsoring this commission. So like, YouTube paid promotion in the Victorian era. There's so much to see in the cathedral. Like this cross carved out from the same piece of wood. Or you could just come for the surfaces. The most famous thing about Christchurch is no doubt Harry Potter. Choirboys from the Christchurch Cathedral School dress like that. Tourists find them quite fun to watch. I learned in this year's Alumni Weekend that there's a secret door in the hall staircase. There's a faint outline of a doorway, which was a temporary bridge installed when Queen Elizabeth I visited the college in 1566, so that she would have direct access from Tom Quad to the hall without having to set foot outside or walk with the peasants, I guess. This Harry Potter fan could probably tell you more about the film locations, especially how the hall becomes the inspiration for Hogwarts Dining Hall. And now, a little light music. It took me years to appreciate all these college history. When I was a student here, I didn't get why people would pay all this money to see the funny faces. Like this area, one year the water pipe leaked. The college found bones underneath the ground. Could be human remains. In one of these rooms, I got paid something like £7 an hour to invigilate a history exam. The girl used dwindling a lot in her political view. This is Peck Water Quad, where we took our matriculation photo in October, already freezing cold. It's opposite this extraordinary college library, but I've only used it twice. Many of us may be eager to live life in the fast lane. But I regret not taking the slow lane and do things that only students would do. That's my biggest takeaway.